This is YPHR, the radio home of your Youngstown Phantoms. And now it's time for Inside the Glass, the official Youngstown Phantoms radio show. Here's your host, Sean Stewart, and voice of the Phantoms, Matt Lipsack.
Welcome to this week's episode of Inside the Glass. Sean Stewart here with you. Matt Lipsack, unavailable to be with us this week, but we have a great show for you this week as we look back at last week's games, talk about this upcoming week's games against the Lincoln Stars, as well as give you some updates on some Phantoms alum in the Frozen Four, as well as some Phantoms alum making their NHL debuts. But first, a word from our season presenter, UPMC Sports Medicine.
If you want to prevent or recover from an injury, learn how to safely push the bounds of your own limitations, or hone your performance for demanding physical activities, UPMC Sports Medicine can help. Their experts use cutting-edge science-based rehabilitation techniques to speed recovery and restore function while focusing on injury prevention, nutrition, conditioning, and activity-specific training for all ages and skill levels. Young or old, pro or amateur, UPMC Sports Medicine has the expertise, advanced technology, and services for athletes. UPMC Sports Medicine, a proud sponsor of the Youngstown Phantoms.
Once again, thanks for joining us on this week's episode of Inside the Glass. We're going to get started by taking a look back at the week that was, where the Phantoms took on the Cedar Rapids Rough Riders and the Chicago Steel in a 3-3. The Phantoms got the weekend started off right with a dominating 3-0 win over the Cedar Rapids Rough Riders on Friday. And after a scoreless first frame, a minute into the second period, Cole Norris blazed up the left wing after a Wasaki faceoff win and netted his 14th of the season.
The Rough Riders, he'll take it against Youngstown's Evan Wasaki. Cleared back out into the neutralized area. Norris brings it ahead for Youngstown. Got behind everybody, shoots and scores.
Evan Wasaki picking up the apple, and what a wrist shot from Norris as he went top shelf, glove side. And the Phantoms would take that 1-0 lead into the locker room. Just 3:21 into the third, Michael Carroll would double the Phantoms' lead as he fired a shot from the blue line through traffic.
They're trying to bring it ahead. Eric Esposito carries it in. His drop pass intercepted by Robert Arik, who takes it back in behind the goal. Arik turns it over, cleared back out to the blue line. Shot, goal! Wow. Shot from the blue line came off the stick of Carroll. But there was some traffic in front, so we're going to wait and see if that one got tipped in or not.
That would be Caro's third of the season from Eric Esposito and Tommy Apap. And with 13 seconds remaining in the game, Pierce Crawford would put the icing on the cake with the empty netter for his 17th of the season and third as a Youngstown Phantom.
Then shot, knocked out in traffic. Cleared off to the side. Phantoms bring it out into the neutralized area. Crossed the center line, backhanded ahead, and there's an empty netter for Crawford.
Ivan Kublikov getting his fourth shutout of the year, stopping all 26 shots he faced. Zach LaRocque taking the loss for the Rough Riders, stopping 20 of 22 Phantom shots. Your three stars from Friday, Michael Caro the third, Cole Norris your second star, and the first star of the night was Ivan Kublikov. And we'll move to Saturday, and much like Friday, the Phantoms were able to get out early, and they started the scoring at 10:23 of the first while on the Pizza Joe's power play. Brandon Estes fired a shot from the point, which was redirected in front by Austin Pooley for his 19th of the season.
Right-hand side, 45 in the man advantage as they tie up along the right-hand boards. Puck squirts away. Messina has it behind his own goal. Caroms it off the boards, knocked out and held in by the Phantoms. Cross-ranking comes Weirbeck. Back out, Estes at the blue line. Shot, goal! Estes took the shot, but I'm thinking they got steered in by Esposito. We'll wait and make sure. But either way, the Phantoms cash in the power play and grab a 1-0 lead at the 10:23 mark of period number one.
Helpers on that Pooley goal went to Brandon Estes and Nicholas Werbeck. The Phantoms would again double their lead as Eric Esposito came flying out of the sin bin and worked the puck below the net and found his brother who was crashing the net.
Trevor Zins has it on the left point, down to the left circle, Walsh, down to the bottom of the circle, cleared around to the near side, Youngstown at full strength, and Esposito out of the penalty box has a break, moving in, shot wide, Zins got back to partially tie him up, now Esposito behind the net, brings it out front, centering pass, they score! Eric Esposito split it across, and tapping it home is Alex Esposito. And the Phantoms get an even strength tally to make it 2-0.
Time of the goal was 13 minutes exactly, and that was Alex's 14th of the season, assisted by his brother Eric and Brandon Estes, picking up his second point of the night. The Phantoms would lead 2-0 after the first frame. Michael Carroll made it 3-0 at 16:01 of the second period, getting his second goal in as many nights.
Controlled by the Phantoms, Pooley skates it out to Nitzel, backhands it down into the Rough Rider end of the rink. Pooley back in behind the net after it there, cleared back around to the near side. Carroll at the point, shot, tip goal! Carroll took the shot from the blue line, but I know that one got redirected on the way in. And Youngstown goes out in front, 3-0, at the 16:01 mark of the second period of play. We'll have to wait and see who gets credit for the tip.
That was Caro's fourth on the year, assisted by Austin Pooley. Cedar Rapids would begin the steep climb back about a minute and a half later while on the power play, as Dalton Messina whacked at a loose puck in front of Britt League that eventually found its way into the net to get the Riders on the board. The Rough Riders would net two more in the third off the sticks of Scott Perunovic and Thomas Vachuska. And despite a late power play in regulation, the Phantoms weren't able to find the back of the twine, and so we would head to overtime. And unfortunately, the Phantoms were called for too many men at 1:13 of the extra frame, and that would be all she wrote, as TJ Walsh would get the winner just 30 seconds later past the outstretched glove of Britt League, getting his first action since December 27th. And so the Riders would take the rematch 4-3. League stopped 28 of 32 shots and would suffer his first loss of his USHL career. Drew DeRitter got the W after stopping 18 of 21 Phantom shots. Three stars were Austin Pooley, Scott Perunovic, and with the game winner, TJ Walsh. Sunday's matinee would conclude the 3-3 for the Phantoms in what could potentially be a first-round playoff matchup between the Steel and the Phantoms, and Mitch Lewandowski would put the Steel on the board just under 15 minutes into the first, but Chase Grisak would answer right back for his 12th of the season.
Former member of the Fargo Force set back in his Steel territory. Toward the cage, stick save by Stezka, rebound, they score. Chase Grisak on the near side, Stezka made the initial save, but Grisak there, the puck bounced over to him, and he had some net to look at. And this game is tied at one with 3:16 remaining in the first period.
And a great goal by Chase, as he was able to work his way around the net and find a loose rebound, which he banged home past Alex Steska. Curtis Hall and Austin Pooley's picking up the apples. 90 seconds later, Reggie Lutz would get his 22nd of the year to put the Steel up 2-1. Nothing on the board in the second, but Lutz would get another at 12:35 of the third, and Jason O'Neill would stick the dagger in the Phantoms, getting an empty net goal with 20 seconds remaining. Kublikov took the loss, stopping 29 of 32 shots, and Alasteska would get the win, stopping 25 of 26 shots. Mitch Lewandowski, Alasteska, and Reggie Lutz were your three stars. And so, the stage is set for the final four games of the year, all very, very important for the Phantoms as they fight for that fourth and final playoff spot. They'll take on the Lincoln Stars this weekend and finish off the year against the U-17s of the United States National Development Program. All games set for a 7:05 puck drop, and great seats are always available. Call 330-747-PUCK to help cheer on your Phantoms as they look to secure that final playoff spot. And be sure to click over to segment two to hear what head coach Brad Patterson's thoughts are on this weekend's games, the Frozen Four, and much, much more. Go ahead and click on over.